Hello friends, so this is the second video of Basic of Finance. So in this video we are going to learn a very important concept called assets versus liability. Okay, so if you talk about our financial journey till now, finance can be basically divided into two parts. One is called a personal finance. Currently we are focusing only on the personal finance. There is a something called a corporate finance, which is basically tackled by the organizations, companies. Okay, so we discussed like in the personal finance, first our objective should be very clear, like whether we want to become a rich or whether we want to become a wealthy. They just don't want to spend their money, whatever they have. They also would like to grow their wealth. So now in order to understand the grow their wealth, first you should know how much your wealth is, isn't it? So that wealth basically we can categorize into two category. One we call is the asset, another we call is the liability. So today we are going to discuss what is the difference among them and why they are so much important for us. Okay, so asset is basically nothing which gives us a money. Okay, so which is basically will provide the money in the future, not now maybe, but which can give us the money basically. Liability, which we want to give the money to others. So in that finance language we say the item we owns are the asset and the item we owe to others is basically the liability in simple definition. Okay, so what is it basically? Asset is a financial resource. Okay, so if anything problem comes, we can actually sell our asset, get the money, and that is helpful for us. Whereas the liability is a obligation, like you have taken a loan, you have taken any kind of debt. Okay, so that is basically your liability. Now the next is depreciation. Depreciation is a very interesting concept. Okay, depreciation meaning is reduction in the value of any items. So for an example, you can say your car is an asset. Okay, so let's say you bought a car from the showroom which is costing you 10 lakh. Let's say after 2 years if you want to sell, it will not give you the 10 lakh. The price may be, let's say, 6 lakh. So the 4 lakh has been depreciated, even though your car is an asset that you can sell at any point of time and get the money, but the value is depreciating. But liability doesn't depreciate. If you have taken a loan from, let's say, bank, it will not happen like after 2 years you will give the less loan. No, it is not like that. You need to keep on basically giving the same amount of loan, whatever is you have taken. Position in the balance sheet. So when you talk about the balance sheet, is nothing but many kind of organization basically, or at a personal level also you can write down what is the basically assets and liability. It is a collection of asset and liability at a company level. Okay, so we can also create the balance sheet for individual level. So generally the asset in that we put in the right side of the column and liability is kept on the left side of the column. So I will show you like this, so you can see here. If you see, like, this is the basically the balance sheet, okay, of one of the organization, or just for the sample purpose, you see the asset is written on the right hand side. Under the asset there are so many items. What are the stocks, debtors, prepaid expenses, goodwill, land, plant, furniture, all these are the asset which are there, and corresponding value. Liabilities, like how many as the trade creditors, expenses, bank overdraft, long term, short term, interest, capital, all those things are basically your liabilities. Okay, so move on to the last part, classification. So we can categorize the assets and liability into two buckets. One we call is the current asset, another is called a non-current asset. What is the meaning of non-current and current? Similarly in the liability, current meaning is it is basically defined based on the time period. If you are able to liquidate, or if you are able to encash any asset within 1 year of time frame, then we call it a current asset. If it is you are able to liquidate after 1 year, then it is a non-current asset. Same thing with the liability. If you are planning to pay any loan within a year, then it is a current liability. And if you are planning more than a year, then it is a non-current liability. Okay, simple example, let's say you have taken a loan of 10 lakh and you are basically going the EMI mode. So that means in a 1 year, 12 EMI, whatever is the amount that you are going to pay, that will come under the current liability, and the remaining tenure that you are going to pay will be non-current liability. Similar concept is for asset, correct? So hope you understand what is the difference between the assets and the liability. Okay, so Now the summary, when we can say asset is basically the make you the money, whereas the liability cost you the money. Okay, so we should not confuse between these two items, asset versus liability. Hope this is clear to you. Thank you.